grow up, Donald. Grow up. Time to be an adult. You're president. You got to do something. Show us what you have. You're going to propose it in legislation. We're going to get to debate it. Let the public decide. Let them vote in Congress. Let's see what happens.
There was a lot there in that interview. Vice President calling out the president-elect Donald Trump, saying, knock off the tweets. Want to bring in Juan Williams and Mercedes Schlapp, Fox News contributors and former media spokeswoman for President George W. Bush. How you guys doing? One
Wonderful.
In a million and mercy, mercy me. I don't know. Biden was talking about taking him out in the backyard as a grade school kid and getting in a fight. I mean, I'm just wacky stuff. Do either of you have a problem with the stream of tweets that seem to be coming out regularly starting at 7 o'clock in the morning? Mercy, start with you.
You know, I don't, Bill. I think we have to understand that presidents in history have used the latest technology to be able to send a direct message to the American people, as well as to go around the filter of the media. And so I think for Donald Trump, Twitter has worked. I mean, you look back in 1933 when it was FDR in the fireside chats, when he was able to talk about the crisis that was happening with the American banks, and it was a sense of reassuring the American public. I think for Donald Trump, not only did the Twitter work for the campaign, but I think that it is his mode of communication. It is where he feels comfortable and able to make announcements, to talk about the work that he's doing every single day. And I think that it's a transparent effort by the president to ensure that the American public hear directly from him.
Okay, all right. I understand every point you made there. And Juan, I think it's a remarkable thing to see how he drives the news cycle every morning.
Yeah.
Is there a downside to this? Or is the idea about going around the media, communicating directly to tens of millions of people, is that actually a modern way of saying this is the way we are going to be the most effective with our message?
Well, it's effective. I mean, there's just no arguing that it was effective during the campaign. And as you point out, Bill, it controlled the news cycle. It had the media chasing Donald Trump at every moment. You know, just this week, Wall Street Journal had a story about his effort to reorganize the intelligence agencies. He came out and just tweeted, you know, lying press or misleading press or whatever he had to say and undercut that story. My feeling about this is it's bigger than what Joe Biden had to say, because you have to think about it. It's only 140 characters. Can you really make policy as the American president in 140 characters? Are you going to be at times misunderstood? Are you going to be taken as bullying, as acting childish? And by the way, Donald Trump has accused me in terms of my criticism of being childish about him. So I don't know that I'm the one to come on here and say anything about that. But he's a guy that is now going to be president of the United States. He's not going through a press secretary. He's not going through a communications director. He's just issuing like a blast, like shouting at somebody on a street corner through a bullhorn. That's what a tweet is.
Well, you don't have to wait for a press conference. You don't have to wait for a statement.
But you don't understand it. You don't even know what the full policy is.
You don't have to wait for an army of people to decipher every word and edit it time and again. Mercedes, do you have any knowledge as to whether or not he is still writing these tweets? Because he hired people, you know, I mean, that's a process that's happening every day. Has he now channeled his voice to people like Scavino or Steve Bannon?
You know, I couldn't tell you that, but I can tell you that it really is, I mean, his words. I think at the end of the day, what you do see is you see Kellyanne Conway and Sean Spicer and his team, very strong communications team, coming out and being able to defend, talk about what Donald Trump is thinking. I think that clearly there is this very strong sense that this is coming directly from Donald Trump. And I have to tell you, I think for the American people, it's reassuring. It lets people know exactly what he's thinking at the moment that he's tweeting this out. And I do believe that it's a very much of a top-down approach. With that being said, I think that his team is very much involved in the process of ensuring that they're able to further discuss or further explain beyond the 140 characters.
Juan, jump in here again. Sounds to me like you guys have a lot of agreement, actually.
Here's the problem. I don't like the bullying part. Like when he calls the leader of the Democrats in the Senate, Chuck Schumer, the head clown, right? I think, oh my gosh. And I, by the way, I agree with Mercedes, as you point out, Bill. I think this is coming directly from Donald Trump. When he goes after President Obama, says Obama's inflammatory rhetoric, or Schumer as head clown, or when you see Spicer go on TV.
I mean,
hang on. When you see Spicer go on TV and try to explain away something, and then Trump comes back and contradicts his own spokesman, I think that's evidence this is coming directly from Donald
Quickly,
Trump.
Quickly, Mercedes.
Well, I think, you know, the Democrats have called Donald Trump so many different names, from racist to sexist. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. So for Donald Trump to make this comment about Schumer, I mean, come on, let's be real. The name calling has been going both ways.
Joe Biden has his own name on that bullying tactic.
I'm going to get this in. I wish we were in high school. I could take him behind the gym. That's what I wish.
Come on.
Wow.
Come on.
Oh, man.
Seriously,
Nick Martial Arts for 70-year-olds.
Have a great weekend. Yeah. See you, Mercedes.
See you guys.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Grow up, Donald. Grow up. Time to be an adult. You're president. You got to do something. Show us what you have. You're going to propose it in legislation. We're going to get to debate it. Let the public decide. Let them vote in Congress. Let's see what happens.
There was a lot there in that interview. Vice President calling out the president-elect Donald Trump, saying, knock off the tweets. Want to bring in Juan Williams and Mercedes Schlapp, Fox News contributors and former media spokeswoman for President George W. Bush. How you guys doing? Juan and a million and mercy, mercy me. I don't know. Biden was talking about taking him out in the backyard as a grade school kid and getting in a fight. I mean, I'm just wacky stuff. Do either of you have a problem with the stream of tweets that seem to be coming out regularly starting at 7 o'clock in the morning? Mercy, start with you.
You know, I don't, Bill. I think we have to understand that presidents in history have used the latest technology to be able to send a direct message to the American people, as well as to go around the filter of the media. And so I think for Donald Trump, Twitter has worked. I mean, you look back in 1933 when it was FDR in the fireside chats, when he was able to talk about the crisis that was happening with the American banks, and it was a sense of reassuring the American public. I think for Donald Trump, not only did the Twitter work for the campaign, but I think that it is his mode of communication. It is where he feels comfortable and able to make announcements, to talk about the work that he's doing every single day. And I think that it's a transparent effort by the president to ensure that the American public hear directly from him.
Okay, all right, I understand every point you made there. And Juan, I think it's a remarkable thing to see how he drives the news cycle every...
You know, I couldn't tell you that, but I can tell you that it really is, I mean, his words. I think at the end of the day, what you do see is you see Kellyanne Conway and Sean Spicer and his team, very strong communications team, coming out and being able to defend, talk about what Donald Trump is thinking. I think that clearly there is this very strong sense that this is coming directly from Donald Trump. And I have to tell you, I think for the American people, it's reassuring. It lets people know exactly what he's thinking at the moment that he's tweeting this out. And I do believe that it's a very much of a top-down approach. With that being said, I think that his team is very much involved in the process of ensuring that they're able to further discuss or further explain beyond the 140 characters.
Juan, jump in here again. Sounds to me like you guys have a lot of agreement, actually.
No, well, look, here's the problem. I don't like the bullying part. Like, when he calls Stood, are you going to be taken as bullying, as acting childish? And by the way, Donald Trump has accused me in terms of my criticism of being childish about him, so I don't know that I'm the one to come on here and say anything about that. But he's a guy that is now going to be president of the United States. He's not going through a press secretary. He's not going through a communications director. He's just issuing like a blast, like shouting at somebody on a street corner through a bullhorn. That's what a tweet is.
Well, you don't have to wait for a press conference. You don't have to wait for a statement.
But you don't understand it. You don't even know what the full policy is.
You don't have to wait for an army of people to decipher every word and edit it time and again. Mercedes, do you have any knowledge as to whether or not he is still writing these tweets? Because he hired people, you know, I mean, that's a process that's happening every day. Has he now channeled his voice to people like Scavino or Steve Bannon? Good morning.
Yeah.
Is there a downside to this? Or is the idea about going around the media, communicating directly to tens of millions of people, is that actually a modern way of saying this is the way we are going to be the most effective with our message?
Well, it's effective. I mean, there's just no arguing that it was effective during the campaign. And as you point out, Bill, it controlled the news cycle. It had the media chasing Donald Trump at every moment. You know, just this week, Wall Street Journal had a story about his effort to reorganize the intelligence agencies. He came out and just tweeted, you know, lying press or misleading press or whatever he had to say and undercut that story. My feeling about this is it's bigger than what Joe Biden had to say, because you have to think about it. It's only 140 characters. Can you really make policy as the American president in 140 characters? Are you going to be at times misunderstood?